all colleagues. I would like to represent the result of the Sera surveillance conducted in 2014 and 2015 to better understanding the spread dynamic in the Anatolia. So the just a background, the Anatolia region of Turkey is endemic with FMD. At the moment, risk-based control program already launched and implemented. Regular FMD NSB sera surveillance has been carried out in Anatolia to better understanding the spread dynamic under the national systematic the surveillance program. So one of the unique indicator, the NSB surveillance in our the systematic the surveillance program. So before the results, I would like to represent some the challenge for the FMD and also the, some characteristic the husbandry system. East Anatolia impact on the disease dynamic is so important because this area, the borderline of the east neighboring countries, and this is the generally the entrance of the new incursion, located long border, and there is an imbalance of the live animal price and also meat price. This is the induced much more the illegal movement. And also this is the climate condition, the high elevation, hard winter and long winter condition, also one of them the challenge of the control of the disease. So another one, the common grazing and the Yayla system, the getting the difficulties, the disease management. So most important things, that's area, the generally the up to 2 years, then to keep the young animal and the grazed and to get the fixed and the sell to the other regions, generally in the central Anatolia for the as a source of the raw materials. So that's the causing a irregular the animal movement situation. So another one, the dense young animal population, generally the lack of the booster vaccination. And finally, the one of the elements is the lack of the disease awareness that area. In the counterpart of the west of the country, generally has some advantages because existing more dairy farms there, more awareness, disease awareness, well-organized the farmers, and generally that's area the, yes, spread the, transmit the disease from the east, but the outbreaks generally with the low incidence rate. Sometimes just limited the one farm within this several few animals, so that's area the more improved the disease awareness. In the between, the central Anatolia is between the characteristic by the husbandry system and the disease dynamic. So objective of the sera surveillance, then two categorized, one of them the approach for the large ruminants. To estimation of the virus circulation in the large ruminants, stratified each region in the Anatolia, so the for design. But the small ruminants, considered the one epidemiological unit, whole Anatolia, to get roughly estimation of virus circulation in the small ruminants population. So design, main the concept of the design, we use the two-stage sampling strategy. Primarily sampling units, we consider the village, And we calculated the number of the village in the each region to be sampled. And based on the some criteria, the statistical criteria, I am not going to detail. The second secondary sampling units is the within the selected village number of the animal. So based on this, you can see here, then we took the some criteria, the confidence interval, test sensitivity, and some the other consideration. And also we clustered the age between the 4 months and the 24 months to get idea the current disease, the circulation, not the older circulation. So as a roughly sampling characteristic, roughly around 40,000 the sample collected for the both species, the large ruminants and the small ruminants. You can see here the detail. For the large ruminants, per village, the collected the 27 sample, and for the small ruminants, collected 20 sample per village. So again, the clustered all the species between these ages. We use the NSB serology, the SEDI test NSB ELISA, and for analyzing, use the Microsoft Excel program, MetCalc, WinEpiscope, and survey toolbox used for the analyzing of the result. So as a cumulative result, we found the decreased prevalence calculated in 2015 against 2004, low prevalence differences between 2 years. So actually, we calculated the median prevalence for small ruminants is higher than the large ruminants in 2014. So as a summary, in 2014 for the large ruminants, 19%, for small ruminants, around 23%. In 2015, almost the equal prevalence was calculated 13%. So as a part of the large ruminants surveillance result, so we analyzed the first NSB prevalence epi units testing the positive. So we found that by epi units testing positive for 2004, higher than the 2015. So you can see here, is there any pointer? As you can see here, we calculated the more clustered the positivity in per epi unit in 2014 result rather than the 2015. So you can see here in the west of the country, generally lower prevalence calculated than the east. East the more. Here is the legend you can see here. Three category. One of them the individual positivity. The second more than the five positive within the each unit, and the third one is the more than the 10 positive per unit. So we consider generally to compare the incidence, the clinical incidence, we consider more than the 10% each more agreement between this our late previous the surveillance experiences. So we generally analyze this more than the 10 positivity our we assume like a cutoff. Second category of the result analyzing the by age versus to the region, you can see here then 2014 the result, there is a very consistent result calculated by age. There is no differences in the west of the country, but in the east of the country there is a high prevalence, and also the age group of the 19, between the 19 and the 24, significant differences than the other age group. In 2015, again this age group higher than the other age group, but there is no like the consistency in the east area. That means some of the sera collected during the G7 outbreak time, for that reason the influence of the new outbreak in the this NSB serology result. So this is the prevalence by region and the provinces for the large ruminant sera surveillance. You can see again the considerably low prevalence in the west area and the higher the prevalence in the east area for each year. But the differences between the years in the consisted the per provinces the similar in the region, but here the some provinces very high than the other in the same region. That means if the transmit the A outbreak in 2015, then this the resulted the high NSB prevalence. That's again, I said before, the sample collected during the episode of the A outbreak. So you can see here the map distribution more clear the result here. The differences between 2 years, here there is an accumulation in the northeast area provinces, higher NSB prevalence here, but there is no like the accumulation in the same by the 2015 result. Although the high NSB prevalence detected in different area, but not looks like the 2014. So this explanation is again the time of the sampling, because when the transmitted disease the after the A outbreak episode, this influenced some high NSB prevalence in the also the west of the country in the some province. So I am just try to summarize also the small ruminants. Almost same characteristic we found the false small ruminants with some differences. One of them, the differences, is the small ruminant population in the west of the country was affected rarely by 2015 new outbreaks wave.
Nachi, can you conclude?
I am going to summarize. This is the characteristic again, the similar by age and the region with the large ruminants, and also this is the distribution of the again. This is the map distribution of the NSB prevalence. Here is the significant differences. 2015, the NSB prevalence in many provinces the lower than the 2014. In the small ruminants. So, as a conclusion, High NSB prevalence for the large ruminants was detected mainly in the east of the country in 2014, reflecting with the FMD split dynamic situation occurred in the previous years. Why we conclude this? Because the significant differences calculated the clustered age group between the 19 and the 24 months animal population. So second conclusion, by region, NSB prevalence was detected in the best of the country compared with the east, its significant differences with the lower prevalence. So another, our assumption is, in our the previous to the experiences of in Turkey, the serology result and also the outbreak data result, suggesting the rarely cause serotype A outbreaks rarely causing the small ruminants. So we assume that the 2015 small ruminants lower NSB prevalence can be explained by this assumption.
Okay, Nachi, sorry, I'm afraid we have to wrap up there, I'm afraid, because of time. So, but there'll be chance for discussion later and for tomorrow. I'm really sorry, but we just have to move on because it's well over time. So, okay. Sorry. Okay. So, no time for questions, I'm afraid, but thank you very much.
Okay. Now we have two.